Living out of a suitcase is a very interesting challenge, and there are some experiences that I guess just aren't relatable because there's not that many people who live that long out of a suitcase. But one of my kind of funniest things that happens is that people who love me think, "Aw, she lives out of a suitcase. That means she doesn't have a lot of things. We should give her some." And it happens all the time. Like, my friend shows up to meet me for coffee, and she's got a bag of clothes. She's like, "Oh, this is her sweater, in fact, and these boots are from a lady in Peterborough." And it's great. I love hand-me-downs, but it means something else has to go. Or what ends up happening, really, is that I'll end up with a bag of clothes that doesn't fit into the suitcase, and then I've got really dear friends who let me keep the bag of clothes in their closet until the next time I'm through, which means I have annual reunions with bags of clothes. And it's kind of awesome. Like, there's a ritual to it. I arrive, I usually make some tea, have a shower from the flight, and then go through the bag. And the bag, almost always, half of it, I go, "What the hell was I thinking hanging on to this? I didn't miss it, I didn't remember it, I don't need it." Off it goes to whatever regional Salvation Army-ish thing is there. And the other half is like, "Yes, I totally, oh, I love this sweater." Or whatever. And on one such bag reunion, there was a purse in the bag, and I looked at the purse and thought, "What the hell did I keep this for? This is broken, zipper's broken, stained, strap is broken, ugly. I don't even use that kind of purse anymore because it's not healthy for your back. What the fuck?" And before throwing it out, I thought, "I'm gonna look through all the pockets just to make sure. Maybe there's a diamond ring, or I don't know, maybe there's some letter, I don't know what, who can remember?" And the only thing I found, it wasn't empty. What I found was a almost empty pouch of drum tobacco and one rolling paper, and I had quit smoking for a year. And it was a massive, oh fuck, damn it, I have to smoke. It was exactly enough for one cigarette, and there was no way I wasn't gonna, it was like destined. And I think it was destined because I wrote the song while I was smoking that cigarette. Now, the song is called Hallelujah. It's not because of the nicotine. If you've ever smoked and started again, you know it's disgusting. I did totally relapse and I still smoke, but whatever. The song is called Hallelujah. Pocket, I found a smoke a year after I quit, and I stopped and wondered if I should, and then I thought, fuck it, and I poured myself a glass of wine and with ceremony lit it. I thought about the time I've lost having that same old fit, the one that tells me I'm not good enough, though I know that I'm strong, and I've fought off every demon, tried to prove me that I'm wrong. And I've got a friend in every town, and still I don't belong. And my best friend has always been a song. But hallelujah for the spirit that remains, and hallelujah for the sounds of sweet refrains. I can pack my life into a box and hop that same old train. Just as long as I keep moving, nothing's lost. Nothing's gained. Well, everybody's growing up, time is showing on their face. And despite the best of all advice, it still feels like a race. And I'm fine as long as I am being held in an embrace. But you cannot spend forever in one place. Sneaky and you're cold, and I don't know who scares me more, the young the old. It feels just like a card game you can fake or you can fold. But there aren't so many winners, so I'm told. But hallelujah for the spirit that remains. Hallelujah for the sounds of sweet refrains. I can pack my life into a box and hop that same old train. Just as long as I keep moving, nothing's lost, nothing's gained. Well, that cigarette burned quickly, and it left me wanting more. But it wasn't more to smoke, I don't know what I smoked it for. Cause it ended and I felt just as I'd felt before. Ceiling still above me and below me still the floor. I don't know what I've been expecting. It's a magical thing. As if I could turn around and suddenly I'd have real wings. I don't know what to call this dream that stubbornly still clings. But every day the same old cycle brings. But hallelujah for the spirit that remains, and hallelujah for the sounds of sweet refrains. I can pack my life into a box and hop that same old train. Just as long as I keep moving, nothing's lost, nothing's gained. Same old train, just as long as I keep moving.